Hey, this is Dan Reeser. I'm VP of Growth at Karura and Acala, and today I'm going to be giving you a quick overview of what Karura is. Karura is what we call the DeFi hub of Kusama, and is also the sister network of Acala, which is being built as the DeFi hub of Polkadot. So we're going to go over what Kusama is because you need to understand that before we go into Karura. And then for Karura, I'm going to explain the products, the architecture, the KAR token, as well as the decentralized sovereign wealth fund. So first, Kusama and Polkadot are both these multi-chain ecosystems that are being built to connect and secure multiple different blockchains. Each of these blockchains is called a parachain and can be customized for a specific purpose, including DeFi like Karura on Kusama and then like Acala on Polkadot. Polkadot and Kusama are called cousin networks. These are almost identical in nature. They both have multiple blockchains, they both have validators, they're both proof of stake networks, and they also will be bridged as soon as they launch. Kusama and Polkadot were both founded by these three guys, Gavin Wood, Rob Habermeyer, and Peter Chabon. Gavin Wood invented the Ethereum virtual machine and created the Solidity programming language when he was one of the co-founders of Ethereum and has gone on to found Polkadot and Kusama. Kusama, like I said, is this multi-chain ecosystem of connected blockchains, and each of these blockchains can be customized for a specific purpose. In Karura's case, the blockchain was customized specifically for DeFi. You'll have gaming chains, identity chains, music chains, pretty much unlimited possibilities for what can be built on Kusama. And I'll get into Karura, of course, in this presentation. Kusama, to be more specific, is an innovation network that's kind of a fast-moving place for developers to come in and experiment and try things out. And things move pretty quickly because the governance system moves on a 7-day time frame instead of 28 days like Polkadot. So developers love it. It's fun to build in this ecosystem because you can really get things done quickly. It's also a proof of stake network that's operated by the KSM token. And when we say a low barrier to entry, this means that in total cost, if you want to use dollar value, it'll most likely be a little bit more inexpensive to launch a parachain on Kusama than it will be on Polkadot. Why did we, as the Karura team, choose to build on Kusama? Well, there's several reasons. Kusama, just like Polkadot, has cross-chain ability, so interoperability between blockchains, the ability to use the Substrate framework to customize our blockchain for DeFi. The network of Kusama and Polkadot are highly, highly scalable in comparison to existing networks. The plug-and-play security is a major aspect for us because we didn't have to, as a parachain team, go out and recruit a whole set of validator nodes with millions and millions of dollars to secure our blockchain. When we win the parachain slot auction on Kusama, we will basically be able to plug in our parachain and inherit that whole network of validators to secure our network. On-chain governance, the ability to make decisions through an on-chain council that's elected by token holders, is another benefit of Kusama. And then last but definitely not least is the ability to self-upgrade without forks. We can continue to upgrade our blockchain for Karura without having to fork the community. So over time, this will be an exponential rate of innovation that we can see with Karura. So with that background, let's get into what Karura is. So Karura is both a platform and a set of applications that we've built on our blockchain. And this is a network that's optimized for speed and innovation as the DeFi hub of Kusama. As I mentioned in the beginning, Acala and Karura are what we're calling sister networks. So Karura is building this DeFi hub for the Kusama community. Acala is building the DeFi hub of Polkadot. These networks will both kind of serve the DeFi demand of each of these communities and will be bridged together. The founding team of Acala and Karura are these four individuals. You've got Rui Tao, Betty, Fu Yao, and Brian. All of them are highly technically competent. They're product and engineering minds. We actually just started bringing on our first few non-engineering people, including myself, recently because the team was so product-focused. And one thing to note too, Brian, our CTO, he's one of the best Substrate developers on Earth. He also started and leads the Substrate Developer Academy globally. So pretty cool to see Brian already giving back to the Substrate community and helping grow more and more of these Substrate developers around the world. Acala and Karura are also backed by some of the top names in crypto, including Pantera, Polychain, Coinbase, Arrington XRP Capital, Digital Currency Group, which owns Grayscale and CoinDesk, our friends at Hypersphere. All these names on the slide, including several others that we didn't have room to fit here. Thanks a lot to all of our backers who kind of helped us get to the point where we are now. Now, Karura, as I mentioned a couple slides ago, is two things. It's a platform, a layer one blockchain, as well as a layer of applications that we've built on our blockchain. So let's look at this in a little bit more detail. At the bottom here is the Kusama layer zero meta protocol that connects all these blockchains together. This provides the security and the cross-chain communication of value and data. And then this is a very different concept than what we're used to with networks like Ethereum, because with Substrate, these little building blocks you see here, these are what sometimes you'll hear referred to as Substrate pallets or modules. We can actually begin building, and we already have, building products or these DeFi primitives into the blockchain itself instead of on the blockchain. So the Karura DEX that you see here is an AMM-style DEX similar to Uniswap. kUSD stablecoin, this is a multi-collateral crypto-backed stablecoin similar to DAI. Liquid KSM staking is another product that I'll get into. We have our own Oracle system, governance, treasury, and then not to mention the Acala EVM. So the Acala EVM is an environment for ourselves or any team from the Ethereum ecosystem to build using Solidity and all the tools that they're used to using within the Ethereum ecosystem. What this also allows us to do is to customize specific features within the EVM that help improve the user experience. So you may have used Ethereum or Matic or BSC, some of these DeFi platforms where you have to actually go out and find the native token of that platform like ETH to do anything, to pay a transaction fee. Basically every click costs ETH. With Bring Your Own Gas, we've figured out the ability to allow users to pay gas fees in any token. So as an example, you can bring over ETH or Bitcoin to Karura, and your first transaction fee you can actually pay with the token that you have in your wallet. So if you have BTC, if you have the KUSD stablecoin, doesn't matter. You can basically choose whichever token is in your wallet and pay the fee with that token. Much easier. Now let's move up one layer. So the Karura applications we've actually built as a way to kind of showcase what we've built on the blockchain layer. So the Karura applications are leveraging those DeFi products or primitives within the blockchain to create an experience that users can use on the front end. So swaps using the DEX, Earn, which uses kUSD as a way to basically take out loans with the kUSD stablecoin, and you can earn using becoming a liquidity provider and what have you. Borrow, same thing with the stablecoin. And then liquid staking, I'll get into on one of the next slides, but this gives people the ability to stake their KSM and then get a receipt in return for that that they can use within DeFi while their underlying KSM continues to be staked and earning returns. So to summarize, three of the products, kUSD stablecoin, the Karura DEX, and the liquid staking are three core products. And then the centralized sovereign wealth fund, I'll get into at the end, but it's another key product that differentiates us quite a bit from other parachain teams. So here's a look at the UI. So if you think back to that last diagram, this is the top layer, the application layer that you and I can actually use on the front end. With the Karura dollar, what people will be able to do is collateralize different cryptocurrencies like KSM, like BTC, to generate a loan, a self-service loan of KUSD, which is the Karura dollar. We believe that, first of all, Karura will be highly beneficial to the entire Kusama community and community of parachain teams, because these products, including the Karura dollar, will likely be highly utilized by other teams. if you're building a privacy chain or an Ethereum optimized chain, all of those teams can leverage the kUSD stablecoin since we're all in this cohesive Kusama ecosystem. Liquid KSM staking looks kind of like this. Of course, on the slide here, you'll see DOT and Liquid DOT. In Karura's case, this will be KSM and Liquid KSM. What this does is several things. It removes the need to wait 7 days to unbond. You can instantly unbond for a small fee. There's no staking minimums. You can stake trustlessly with the ability to earn rewards on the KSM that is staked while also getting LKSM in return. So as you can see here on this in the UI on the left, you would actually go in, choose how much KSM you want to stake. It would tell you how much LKSM that you're getting in return, and you would click stake. And then your balance on the Liquid KSM would actually show you what you have in Liquid KSM then. The cool thing is too, that as your KSM that's staked continues to earn rewards, the rewards will then be reflected in your LKSM balance. So your LKSM balance will continue to go up because the rewards are continuously flowing into your balance. Perform swaps with the Karura DEX. So this is very similar if you've used Uniswap. This is an AMM style DEX that we will be offering very soon after launch as well. So to reiterate, Acala and Karura are both being built. Karura being built to serve the DeFi demand of the Kusama ecosystem, and Acala being built to serve the DeFi demand of the Polkadot ecosystem. We look at this just like a traditional company might look at opening up a different branch in different countries, where of course there's demand in those different places, so you open up a shop there. Same with us. We will be running these networks in parallel, in perpetuity, so they will continue to work with one another. Now, the KAR token, I've mentioned KUSD is the stablecoin. KAR is the transaction fee token or the governance token for the Karura network. I won't go into the details on all these different categories, but ultimately, every transaction will be paid in the underlying network using KAR. When I mentioned that you can pay gas fees in any token, what actually happens on the back end is that if I pay the gas fee in BTC, that gets routed to the Karura DEX automatically in the back end, gets swapped for KAR, and then the gas fee itself gets paid in KAR. Makes it easy on the user and still allows the network to accept the KAR token as the transaction fee. This will also be the way that people can participate in governance, so electing people to the Karura Council, voting on things, that will all be done with the KAR token. Distribution, I'll break down very quickly. We've got backers and early backers here. The founding team has 10%, and then the community has a very large share of around 61%. And then when you break down that community portion, we've got a part for the auction, the parachain auction reward, and the liquidity provider program that we'll be launching. Ecosystem development, the treasury will have its own reserve there to help grow and foster growth within the network, and then an additional 10.25% as a reward reserve that we can use in the future. The Karura Treasury and Decentralized Sovereign Wealth Fund is definitely something that I wanted to mention. So the Karura Treasury will be funded over time and built up continuously using network surplus or revenue that's generated from these DeFi protocols. This Karura Treasury is owned and managed and governed by all the KAR holders on the network. It's basically a shared treasury, just like we've seen with the Kusama Treasury, the Polkadot Treasury. One thing that's new, though, is we're introducing this concept of the Decentralized Sovereign Wealth Fund, where we can actually evolve into a self-sustaining network, because when our first parachain auction happens, we will be doing a crowd loan to crowdsource KSM to support our bid in the parachain auction. But we don't always want to have to do that in the future. So what we hope and plan for is that this DSWF will allow us to build up our own funds so that the network itself can bid and win a parachain auction in the future instead of needing to do a crowd loan again. This treasury and DSWF over time will own its own assets. It could own foreign assets such as KSM, and will definitely be something interesting to follow as we launch. And that's it. Hope you learned something about Karura. If you go to our link tree, there's all the resources that you'll need to learn about Karura. And we appreciate your support, and let us know if you have any questions. Thank you.